Hi, I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. If you just joined us, welcome. This is a series on programming with QML and Qt, and we now made it to the section where we're going to talk about transformations. It's actually going to be two videos. The first one, I'll show you the transformations that are kind of built in, and the second video that will be right after this one, we're going to see how you can customize the very tiny details of transformations on your items. Transformations is something that you do to any item. In this video, we'll see transformation done to images, but you could do transformation on any of the other elements that exist in QML. The transformation is a hierarchy of, or you have a hierarchy of element, and the transformation apply to whatever elements in that hierarchy and all of its children, which is the key thing. See, I got a beautiful rocket here that my five-year-old daughter drew to me. Okay, it was me. I'm not very good at drawing. But anyway, I got a drawing here. And this item here might have another child item. So I'll just imagine we had a child item sitting underneath it. Whenever I do some transformation in this one, for example, rotating. See, my green little post-it note here rotated together with the rocket. So transformations applies to the whole tree underneath. This is a bit surprising, as we'll see in the next example here, when we talk about opacity. When we talk about that an element is transparent, then its children is transparent too, though the children stand on top of the element. But we'll see that when we get to that slide. We have at least these three different transformations that we can apply: opacity changing, scaling, and rotating of our elements. If we want something more than just that, we can actually set up a complete matrix for the transformation, and we'll see how we can do very custom transformation in the next video. But let's start looking at the opacity transformation. I got a bunch of rectangles here. You can see I got a rectangle that is blue. That's the outer one here. In the code snippet, it doesn't show that one. We start at the level here with the white one. But I got that blue rectangle that is the base of everything. My blue rectangle has a white rectangle inside it. That's what you see here. It doesn't really look white to your eyes, and that's not because that we have an error in the example or anything. It's simply because that it's transparent, so it's got 50% opacity, meaning 50% transparent too. So it's 50%. I got a 50% white transparent color, so I see some of the blue through the white, which makes this more white bluish. I got a red one here, and that one has also 50% transparency. And that one is a child of the other rectangle. So here's the outer rectangle. That's the big white one that is light blue in your eyes. And it has a child, and that child is red. That's the red rectangle we see here. It doesn't really look all that red. It looks kind of, I don't know what the color that is, light pink, whatever. I'm not good at colors. But you can see that this is truly red we have down here. It is more reddish, whatever. And why is that? Well, the reason for that is that I got 50% transparency here, 50% transparency there, which makes this 75% transparent. And as I said, even though the child is standing on top of its parent, it inherits the transparency. So you can see it's very transparent here. I got another rectangle for showing this off. And this time you can see there is no opacity here. So this one is a complete solid red. But of course, it inherited 50% transparency. So there is again some transparency towards the parent there. Now, outside of this rectangle, I got another rectangle, and it's 50% transparent. So this rectangle, as you can see, the color here is exactly the same as the color there. So this one inherited 50% transparency of a 100% opaque rectangle. This one is 50% transparent itself. And finally, I got another one here, no opacity, it's a red rectangle, it's standing on top of it, and it's completely red, as you can see. Actually, in the code, and you can load that code up yourself when you get a time for doing that, you'll notice that these four rectangles actually stand outside of their parent. So this is a child of this white bluish rectangle here, but it stands outside of it, which we saw in a previous video is perfectly okay. And you can see the opacity, the 50% opacity also applies to when you are painting outside of your parent. That was opacity. We have two other transformations. We have scaling and we have rotating. Scaling, super easy. We actually saw that in the previous video already. I simply say scale 2.0 here. So now my image is scaled up twice. I could, of course, have just changed the width and the height as we saw in the previous video, but I can also simply say scale. Let me show you an important thing to understand about this. Here's the example. Let's just run it to see what we have. We have a rectangle, we have a rocket standing on a blue background. At this stage in your learning, hopefully not very surprising what we saw there. But let's try and put a rectangle around this image here. The rectangle would be, let's just make it, I don't know, make it red, right? So red. And it's gonna be around this one here. Select everything, Control I to make it indent things. And if I run it now, you will notice there's no red rectangle because my rectangle size is 0 by 0 if I don't specify anything. So I have a 0 by 0 rectangle up here. It has a child, the child is outside of the rectangle. Had I said clip colon true, you would notice that now I don't see anything at all because my rocket is not outside of its parent anymore. So let's not do that. Instead, let's give it a width. And the width would be the image width here. So I need to give it a child, so give it an ID. IIM, what a great name, dot width. And the height will be the height of that image. And I just need to uncomment this one here just for a second so you can see it working out. As you can see, it's working out really well. What's the matter here? Well, of course, my rectangle. It's position. So my X and Y needs to be like this. Okay, there we are. Here is my red rectangle that is the parent of that rocket. But notice now, if I do my scale here, my red rectangle is still the same size as it was before. The key thing to understand is that when you apply the scale transformation, it's really just for the eyes of whoever sees it. The bounding rects, the size of that element is still gonna be the same. That is gonna be super important when we talk about anchor layout in a few videos from now, because when you do some transformation and you anchor towards something, then you're angered towards the size of the original one. So if I want, I would need to change the width and the height of this element. I could easily do that by simply saying, well, the width here is the image width multiplied by the scale that we had down there. I'll leave that for you to play with at home to see how that works. We also have rotations. And rotation is simply done by writing rotation, colon, and then the angle that you want to rotate. Let me show you my rocket again. I got my rocket here. I'm rotating it. The key question to ask, though, is which part of that rocket am I rotating around? I could be rotating around where my fingers is now. So rotating around like this. I could be rotating around the topmost what's that going to be? Topmost leftmost corner here for you, like this, or the topmost rightmost corner, or any other location I could be rotating around that. That is specified using transform origin. Let me run the example. You can see that the rocket is rotated. it's rotated by default around the center. So if this whole item, if this whole piece of paper was the rocket item, then it's the center, the width divided by two, the height divided by two, that's that center point is where I'm rotating around. If I want, I can change that transform origin and then item dot, I think it's called top left. There we are. And now you can see that I'm rotating around a different point. Let's try to visualize this. Let's just try and comment these two out and see where we are. Here is a rocket. A mental note to yourself that the rocket is, well, it's 50 pixels in and 35 down. If I do the transformation but without the transform origin, you can see that the rocket was around here. So this is the center of the rocket and this is where I'm rotating around. But if I do the transform origin and run again, you'll notice that now the rocket is transforming around this corner that was sitting up there, rotating 45 degrees. And we can go to the documentation here. If I couldn't remember, I almost couldn't, that it was called item.topLeft, I could always go to F1 on my transform origin, which would send me right to this documentation here where I can see the different positions that we have. So top left, top right, and so on. These are different transformation points that I can transform around. Jesper, what if I want to transform around this point? You didn't have a point there. How could I do that then? I'm so glad that you asked me that question, because that leads us straight into the next video where I'll show you how you can do transformation around any point, where you can do any transformation that you can think of using a matrix or something less drastic than that. That's going to be the next video. Please do subscribe to our channel so that you can be notified whenever that's online. And if it's already online, well, there might be other videos coming online later on. Thank you very much.